Hey y'all, welcome back to another hair vlog. I thought I was gonna be washing my hair tonight because your girl is turning at 28 tomorrow, May 31st, and I wanted to wear my hair out and curly, but time kind of got away from me, so I've been wearing my hair in these little buns with the scarf at the top. Like, I saw it on Pinterest a while back, and I actually did it last year. I put it here, and I haven't done it in a while. I've already worn my hair like this 3 times because it's just so easy, so I can smooth this and cover that up, and you can't even tell. So I'm probably gonna be wearing my hair like this again tomorrow. I wanna try this new product that I'll probably get into later on next week. I just wanna open up this vlog with checking in with y'all, seeing how you've been, how you're doing. I've been good. I've been busy between trying to just keep up with life and wedding planning. I'm managing. I'm trying not to be so hard on myself about things because there's so much that goes on in our life that we cannot control. Okay, yeah, let me go take a shower, do some editing, and go to bed. So I have 15 minutes to get ready before I go to my workout class. So we're gonna do that real quick. And I had my hair in this cute ponytail with this gold string. I'll insert a picture here, but I don't think it would be conducive to work out in. I'll do something a little bit more comfortable. I'm just gonna use one of the scrunchies that I got. I got the scrunchie last year from Curlfriend Collective. She sent like a pack of 3 and they're just so cute. I'm gonna link them down in the description box too, if you're interested in like checking them out. So I've been doing ClassPass because it's way more affordable than paying for a membership, and I get bored so easily. Like, I am a huge advocate for having some sort of hobby, and I feel like that's regardless of the job you have. If you can, shit, honestly, I prefer free hobbies, but if you can put in some hobbies that you pay a little fee for too, ain't nothing wrong with that. But it's just nice to have something to do. Sitting back and trying to figure out, like, why was it so easy for me to stay consistent with working out when I was in college versus now? And realizing it's like that community aspect. So I'm trying Pilates, and so far I've been enjoying it, and Legree as well. I took a private class, and it was the hardest thing that I've ever done in my entire life, but I wanna go back, and I'm gonna go back tomorrow. And I figured that I would just do classes like once or twice a week and walk as my way of getting my movement in. I feel like I'm trying to force the gym, and I don't know if going to the gym is my thing right now. I don't know if it's been my thing for honestly at least like 6 years, because I used to be obsessed. And maybe I'll find my way back to it, but I don't want to force myself into doing something that I don't want to do when I'm trying to be consistent. But yeah, I'm just gonna do this little ponytail. I feel like I need to put it up a little bit higher. That way when I'm laying down, it's not uncomfortable. Why am I such a perfectionist? I love this, but I want it to be a little bit more secure. So I am gonna use a ponytail holder first. I changed my mind. I'm gonna do a ponytail holder first. I'm only wrapping it twice. I'm just pulling it a bit to make sure it's not like super loose. We're gonna do a little test here because we gotta see if things, okay, I got 5 minutes, let's hurry. It's important to know if things actually work before we spend our money on products, you know? And edge control is always the biggest struggle I feel when it comes to natural hair. I feel like this is my tried and true Kiss Edge Fixer. I've been using it for years and it works for me so well on its own. But I found that doing a concoction of the Kiss Edge Fixer with a gel, like EcoStyler, something cheap, EcoStyler wet line, my edges don't move. And we're gonna see, because I'm going to a class where it's not like super high intensity, but I am gonna sweat and I am gonna work, and we're gonna see how my edges hold up. Take a little bit of the Kiss Edge Fixer, and then I take a little bit of the EcoStyler, and I just swoop my little hairs in the front. I kind of just, like, you know, place them along my hairline and brush them back into my ponytail. That's how I like to do my edges. And I promise you, my edges don't move. Hopefully this won't be the day where my edges are like, ha, fooled you. We know you're trying to show off and prove a point. So we gonna show you, we gonna add up today. I like to show how products actually work for me. I feel like that's why I gotta maintain my consistency on YouTube. It takes me a long time to get videos out because I'd be so worried about quality and making sure the editing is right and that I'm not just putting out stuff to put out and then I'm putting out something that, you know, would be enjoyable. So, okay, we're done. We're done. Time. All right, I'm gonna show y'all my little outfit. I'm just wearing a one piece set because it's the easiest. I got it from Free Movement and they're so comfortable. Like, I want these in more colors. I have it in this grayish purplish color in blue. It's like a cobalt blue. So pretty. I'm just gonna brush my brows up a little bit. I thought I was gonna fill them in, but I don't have time to do that. So I'm just gonna use a little tiny bit of some brow gel to brush them up. Like that. I mean, yeah, that didn't really do anything. It's okay. I think it's supposed to rain today, but I'm gonna still put on some sunscreen just to be safe because I never know if I want to take a walk after I leave this class and contemplate my life. So use a little bit of sunscreen and I think I'm ready to go. I almost forgot to put my little cute scrunchie on too, so let's add that real quick. Okay, there's this scrunchie. Okay, this is my little hairstyle that I'm wearing to work out. And I will see you guys afterwards to see how my edges held up. As promised, I had to show you all how my edges look after taking my class. This method is the truth. My edges do not move. When I do that little concoction, tomorrow I am going to be doing a wash and go using the new TGIN Miracle Gel. I used it recently for part of my half up, half down style. And it gave me so much definition that I was like, oh, this is gonna be great for a full wash and go. So I'm gonna be using that tomorrow and showing you guys how the product works. And I've also been obsessed with peonies lately. Look at how beautiful this flower is. I've only seen them in stores during their bloom season, which is like from May through June. And all I know is that I want them on my counter every single day. I'm trying the new TGIN Miracle Styling Gel. As y'all can see, I do not have my wash and go anymore. That wash and go lasts me 8 days, which I think is really, really good. My wash and goes usually last me a long time. Now I'm getting ready to leave out. I need to go to my second dress fitting this week. When I finish my drive, I'm gonna take my braids out and I'm not wearing any makeup today. Just some sunscreen. I went and saw an esthetician over the weekend and I really want to get my skin together this year. I think I've done an amazing job at getting my skin to a better point than what it was before, but now I feel like I just need that extra help. Before I leave, I need to go by the post office and return a package. I got these workout tights from the store online. I saw people talking about, it's called Navigation. I like the sports bras, I like the shorts, but the leggings are see-through. And these are supposed to be leggings that you squat in and they are completely see-through, so I gotta return that. And by the way, I am doing another month-long review. I don't wanna put too much pressure on myself, but any opportunity that I have to review and test a line of products for an entire month, I am taking it. I've been creating content for 6 years, which is crazy for me to even think about, because sometimes I feel like I'm not where I want to be. But at the same time, I am very grateful to be where I'm at, and everything is a journey. Everybody's on their own path, they're on their own journey. And I have to remind myself that even when I'm kind of being hard on myself and I'm like, dang, well, you've been doing this for 6 years and you're not here. Like, I have to remind myself of that, you know? Now I'm spinning my edges back. I might tie my hair back with this because I just love the scarf. And I don't want to, like, add too much extra product on my hair when I haven't even taken the style down yet. It looks like this scarf looks better, though, with, maybe I can tie it around the ponytail. This is how I end up wearing a lot of styles. I'll just be doing random things with my head and whatever I'm using to see how it looks. And then if it's cute, I'll wear it. If not, I won't. I don't think I would do it with this style, but I still feel like with some work, that has potential. Okay, I'm gonna leave that in the vault. I'm gonna try that later, but yeah. Before I go, I just had to show you guys this big old package that came in the mail for me last week, and when I received it, I was so I feel very excited to do a month-long review of those products for you all. I have not filmed anything yet, but I did wash my hair with their products last night. Yeah, so for everybody who's watching this hair vlog right now, you're gonna get a little bit of my first impression. I shampooed with the Rich One Moisture Repair Shampoo. This is for sure a moisturizing shampoo, so it's not clarifying. And I know a lot of people don't like for their hair to feel stripped. So anyone who loves a good moisturizing shampoo that will give you like a gentle cleanse without stripping your hair, that is a good option. Also use the Rich One Moisture Repair Conditioner. So far, I don't feel like I had to use a lot of the shampoo. It still feels really heavy in my hand, but the way this is feeling, I used almost half of the conditioner, or at least a quarter of this conditioner last night. I don't know if I needed to use that much. I think I may have used too much of this product last night because my hair was very, very tangled. And lastly, I used the Home Curl Curl Defining Cream. I used it to do these 6 braids, and let me show you all the consistency of this product. It reminds me of a product that I used to use. I don't even know if they still make products, but they're called Entwine. It was a cream product that was supposed to have like this jelly-like consistency, and this reminds me of that product because look, like, it's very stretchy. You see that? Like, it has a little stretch, a little bounce to it. Products like this, from my experience, for me, they're very concentrated, and because they spread and they stretch like this, I don't have to use a lot of the product. Think about trying products for a good enough time to actually see how they work on your hair, so that your opinions will change. I was able to braid down my entire head. I did pretty chunky braids, but this thing is still full. I haven't used this yet, but this is the jelly type. I've been seeing people use this product for wash and goes, even though it's supposed to be like for slick back styles. I always love to try a new edge control to see how it works and if it actually holds the hair. If not, I like to mix it in with a little something else to give it a stronger hold if I need to, but this is their controlling type edge control. I'm gonna take this with me. I'll be bringing this edge brush too. I won't be showing all the products in this video. You guys have to stay tuned for the month-long review. But again, I want to give you guys like a sneak peek and just my thoughts on the products that I've used so far. And again, like, as I was just talking about me having done like content creation for 6 years, like, I wasn't on YouTube for 6 years, but I've been creating content for over 6 years. I've had to let go of this pressure. Like, oh, okay, this new product just came out. There's not many reviews on it, so let me rush to put it out. I've had to like remove myself from that mindset. Even if the hype has sort of died down on a product, anyone looking for that sort of in-depth review will still be able to find it. That's the route I'm taking, and I've been enjoying it, and I hope that it's been helping you. But I need to get a vlogging camera, y'all. I have my phone, and I think it'll be hard for me to like record. You know what? I'll talk to y'all later. I'm gonna take these braids down real quick before I leave. Wore my hair like this for 2 days, so I'm positive they're dry. Take down this is so smooth. I plaited that section down really good. Because I'll be in the car for a while. It has no shape right now and it's okay. I'm using the Fenty Edge Control to smooth my edges and also to see how it holds up throughout the day because it is almost 100 degrees outside. I'm gonna use this on my mom's edges too. Mm-hmm. Think so?
Well, it is the same color. This because
I'm gonna leave my hair like this in the car and then I'll take it down when I get to where I'm going. I've only used the Fenty Hair Edge Control once since I've been back in Florida. Today I kind of want to compare my concoction that I usually do versus the Fenty, but I think I'm going to mix both with the Eco Styler Gel just to be fair, since that's what I usually do. And then I'll do Fenty Hair again another day on its own. Right now I'm just going to show y'all what I'm doing before I head out. I think I showed this to you guys earlier in this vlog, but I just used the, on this side I'm doing the Kiss Edge Fixer mixed with a little bit of Eco Styler. And then I'm gonna do a little bit of Eco Styler mixed with the Fenty Hair on the other side, although I'm not really sure how well they mix together because I've never mixed any of the Fenty products with anything else. I'm gonna do the Fenty, a little bit of Eco Styler. I'm pretty much out of this. I need to get some more. I'm just scraping from the side of the jar. Tomorrow I'll officially be starting the Fenty Hair review, even though I've been using the products already for a week, but as far as filming for the YouTube video, I'll officially start this weekend. This side, which is my left side, this is the Kiss Edge Fixer side, and this side is the Fenty Edge Control side. This is like the hardest thing I've ever done.